What if I told you that stardom can be achieved by association? That you can reach fame on the shoulders of others? What if I told you that good things don't always happen to good people? That some charges are left unpaid? What if I told you that hard work isn't always rewarded? That recognition is something that is not always earned? The truth is, greatness can be achieved by association.
Mike's good. Perfect. Yeah, so I guess just to start from the beginning, you know, the original core group of the good old boys FC, myself, Handsome Rob, Gary Focus, and Scooter Durant, essentially all kids from Shreveport, Louisiana and the surrounding areas. You know, all growing up, we played for our individual clubs and academies. And at some point, you know, realized we all had a future in professional football. It was just a matter of the fact of who was going to give us that opportunity. And, you know, of course, in our eyes, we thought we were going to go directly to Division I clubs, you know, big names. But that really wasn't the case. Essentially, we got picked up by a Division X club out of Shreveport, good old boys FC, which really was the main reason of, you know, why we played with a chip on our shoulder. You know, we are pretty certain that we could go straight D1, but because the talent and the passion was definitely there. I think it was just mainly the fact that we, you know, we're from Shreveport, and it's a region not really known for, you know, top-class soccer, was the main reason for us getting overlooked. You know, but in the end, you know, us all coming to the same team and playing, we knew that that was going to expedite the process of getting us to where we needed to be, and just made the journey that much sweeter.
Easy out.
Get out. So it'll be a throw in.
Cash
money. Spike. Delivered into the box.
This
is what a game.
Exactly.
They've equalized. Both sides really attacking better than they are defending.
You know me. You know I ride for my motherfucking niggas. Most likely I'ma die with my finger on the trigger. They tell me don't get high, not your drive, make a living. I tell them I'm a hustler, when I rob, I make a killing. My eyes get so wide as it rides in the skillet. I let my bitch bag it if she's stealing, I'ma kill her. I bulletproof the ride, now I feel like I'm a dealist. And fuck your hospital, young money, we the illest. And I ain't gotta lie when I tell you I'm the illest. My flow is nasty, like C.Y. Phyllis. Self-made G and them bitches know the business. Relying on rap, but in the kitchen I'm a chemist. And when I was 5, my favorite movie was The Gremlins. Ain't got shit to do with this, but I just thought that I should mention. You looking for divine and a little intervention. And them birds don't fly without my permission. I'm probably in the sky, flying with the fishes. Or maybe in the ocean, swimming with the pigeons. See, my world is different, like Dwayne Wayne. And if you want trouble, bitch, I want the same thing. You know that I'ma ride with my motherfucking niggas. Most likely I'ma die with my finger on the trigger. Don't worry about mine, I'ma grind till I get it. And tell all of my niggas that the sky is the limit. The sky is the limit. The sky is the limit. And tell all of my niggas that the sky is the limit. Cause the sky is the limit.
Soccer hasn't always been big in the US of A, certainly not down south, and definitely not in southern Louisiana. You see, most people from around here hadn't even heard the word soccer, at least before the good old boys arrived. One of the first big decisions the good old boys executives had to make was where to call home, where to plant their roots, and where to form the flagship of their franchise. They were looking for a place where people worked hard, but played harder. a place where people chugged liquor and whooped ass, a place where no matter what, they knew their fans would have their back. The place they landed was Shreveport, and they put it on the map. Here, a transition occurred. Soccer went from a hobby to a way of life. A large fan base formed, and people flocked to the bayou to see the boys play. Game day no longer meant American football, it meant good old boys football. And by the time they reached Division I, the bayou found a new name for itself, the end of the world. The bayou became a fortress. No one wanted to play there because they knew they were in for it. Here, they took no prisoners, and soon the bayou, the home of the good old boys, became the most hostile venue on the planet. And that brings us to our feature presentation. Looking for teammates, profiling one of our biggest players, Scooter Durant. And don't get me wrong, it wasn't all bad. It started out good. Here you see he finds himself in a good space with a great ball from one of our members, Donnie Harris. He is a bit fortunate there, hitting it off the goalkeeper's hands for it to lob into the goal, but he was banging them in. You see here in another clip, handsome Rob working back well, team finding space, moving the ball. See here, Farkas feeding there, young Scooter who scores the goal, celebrating accordingly, but this is when you can see things start to go sour. You see here from the half-assed celebration and the look that Farkas gives handsome Rob there that they'd had enough. And as the fans' hearts began to go gray on him as well, things started to change around the bayou. And that's what this is all about. Scooter Durant, number one, the magic man, Baba. At least that's what he calls himself. In this clip here, you see handsome Rob working tirelessly as a defender. Something that's not necessarily a role that receives a lot of glory, but lockdown defense nevertheless, and finally trying to relieve some pressure. You see we're up 2-0 early in the game, and Baba calls for it. He takes a poor angle and, you know, springs the counterattack, and I think everybody knows what's about to happen. Of course they're going to score. You know, you can't just push the ball away in our own half and expect anything else, but, you know, you got to take your run wide into the open space if you're going to call for it there. You can't just dribble straight into the defender. Here in this clip, you see Carl receiving the ball off the kickoff, beginning of the game. He does well to find the open man out wide. Finds Baba, who finds someone in the middle, and Farkas calls for it. He's looking to combine here with Baba, but thing is, with Scooter, he's always trying to shoot, never looking to combine or slip anyone, and, you know, it wastes a good goal-scoring chance early. Could have been on top. Here in this clip, Scooter actually does quite well winning the header. He hardly does this, but he wins it. He combines off with Slippy, and you see there's a good chance for him to do a couple of things here. And he's been working on his crosses the past few seasons and just haven't been coming off. But first, he could have slipped Crow early. Didn't do that. He bypasses it. He has a second option, possibly play Tobias in there for the header. Nice lofted cross, early cross, but he instead chooses option 3, which is his worst option. He bypasses option 1 and 2, springing the counter. You can insert a thought there into Baba's thought bubble, because I have no idea what he was thinking.
Just a flick on with the header. Kept
here
possession.
We are on top here, winning a second ball off a goal kick. And player. Once and again, it's another cross. We've been working on this for years and just isn't coming off there. Poor crossing from Baba, and Sanchez, once again springing the counter. At least he's defending this time. Takes danger. A bit of a poor angle there, but nevertheless, and I don't know what ends up happening at the end of that, but I just can assume they scored, and it just takes us to this. It's a perfect opportunity for a 1-2. First thing that all young footballers learn in training, and that's one of the big issues here, is that Baba is nowhere to be found in training. Usually counting his accolades and tallying his goals and assists instead of being in line here. And you see there's Farkas, followed by Hot Carl, followed by Handsome Rob, and even Shosey, our newest member, is joining the 1-2 drill. Baba, nowhere to be found, and it's a big problem for us. Here's just a good graphic of the plotted trajectory of his cross, where he's trying to play a 100-degree ball rather than turning his body and getting his angle right. Just not setting yourself up for success there, mate.
One goal now, and they'll
Here this clip is from a very tense game. This is one of the games where we could have gone from Division 4 to Division 3. It was a very tough time for us as a club, and we've done a lot of score and get back into the game. We know we have about one more play. You see Donnie there working tirelessly defending and actually pressures the ball. We win it back. Farkas gets it, immediately plays it out wide to the open Baba, and we have three, four even players streaking that could have been involved, and he's just chosen to shoot as he always does. And it's the worst choice there, you see.
Here's McDonald.
Here in this clip, he receives the ball out wide.
Danielli.
Immediately plays Donnie under pressure. He's done well two times there to retain possession. And you see Handsome Rob gets the ball. And goodness, what a beautiful ball. You know, you can't possibly mess this up, but oh, he's pilfered it. This is the point for young footballers here. When you have four or five good options and two not so good ones, at least don't play someone under pressure. And also, when you're going to finish, just have some composure, let off the right trigger, release the turbo, and have a tidy finish. Here's a corner kick. Baba likes to put himself on all the corner kicks so that he can get some more accolades, tally some more assists, and he puts himself as the man for the corners there and the rolls every game. Delivers a poor cross. Handsome Rob's there to clean it up as usual there. And here's one of the big things he's doing wrong. If you go back and forth cycling, you see he's moving his thumb as he's powering the corner up. It's always going to lead to an inaccurate ball. Green Asters here is where this ball is supposed to go and where we discuss it in training. And he's played the wrong ball. He's moved his cursor while taking the corner. And even worse, the worst area is he's complimented himself on a good ball when it's a bad one.
Now Robson.
Here you see Rob finding Scooter and he's just had no composure. He's smashed it off Crow's kneecap, and that's just because he's had low mental fortitude, and he's benefited from Crow's deceptive ability. Even though he smashed it off his shin, he does some sort of a acceleration jig. He really puts the goalkeeper off there. As you can see, the user keeper's completely fooled by Crow's move and lets the ball dribble into the ball.
Switch on the attacking power in this
here in this
situation.
Clip, great tackle from Donnie. He's one of our best defenders. He's found Farkas, he's found Rob, he's just played it out wide for, you know, Scooter for another crossing opportunity. He had so much space there. All three of his teammates that were in the box are just beside themselves because he's had 100 square yard area to play this ball into, and this is a Scooter Durant trademark. That's why his signature's there. And Scooter Durant, number one, you know, have a touch, have some composure. You superimpose the amount of space he has around himself before he plays this ball. It's roughly similar to the amount of space that he has to hit. It's just unbelievable. And, you know, at least if you make a bad cross, become the first defender. Take care of your mess up, or you can secondarily become lazy and unaware. And that's what he's chosen here, just laziness. Scooter Durant, number one. He's not tracked back to win the ball. He's just going back to midline to take a rest.
So what happened? Oh, I don't know. If you were to take the good old boys back, what made us successful? It was a brotherhood. It was a collection of people that were willing to do anything for one another. It wasn't about the goals. It wasn't about the fame. It wasn't about the money. We put Shreveport on the map. What broke the good old boys was, well, when you get success, you're gonna get fame, money, a little bit of pressure. And that's what did it. Scooter Durant just turned into something that we weren't about. Instead of that being about, you know, banging in goals and having fun and beating other teams, it was about the individual accolades. When he split and cracked under pressure, that's when we lost it. Scooter found himself addicted. Addicted to the limelight. Addicted to this lifestyle. And addicted to the center stage. With no regard for anyone else.
So I've been playing alongside Scooter Durant for roughly 24 campaigns now. So you can definitely say I've been there for the ups and downs of his career. When we started out in Division 10, and recently here been promoted to Division 1, you can say along the way it's been a bumpy road. In particular for Scooter, you can definitely say it's been spiraling downhill. You know, in the beginning, things were great, things were perfect. The team was flying, performing well, having a lot of success, getting promoted very quickly and moving up the table. You know, it's just got to a point that it's gotten so bad. You know, the nightlife's just grabbing. Having all-night benders before cup matches, big games. When the next day, we need him at his best, performing well. And here recently, it's just been riding the coattails of the hard work and dedication of his teammates within the club. And it's definitely hard to see your mate, you know, on the decline, because the whole thing is bigger than just him. It's bigger than the individual. It's about the team. It's about your brothers. And that's really just been the most difficult thing to watch for this entire process.
Man, that account just... You can hear the emotion in his teammate's voice. So things are really starting to turn for the worst for Scooter Durant. This is perhaps the lowest point of his career. See handsome Rob here working tirelessly to try to open up space. Scooter's moved all of about 2 feet. He's still calling for the ball while it's covered.
That throw is literally tossed possession
takes a
away.
Bad first and second touch there. And this just graphic reminds me to mention our corporate sponsors as part of our trivia. CenturyLink is our communications sponsor here. Suave shampoos and hair products, always for a fresh cut. Copenhagen Mint, long cut, as well as pouches. Delicious. The SEC, the leading conference in college football, as well as War for the Planet of the Apes, which is starring Crow's brother. You know, and part of our trivia, what will happen next year? Will he force him wide and regain possession? Will the opposite team bot kick it out? Will he earn a red card for a rash challenge, or will he put in an astonishing tackle? Go ahead and tally up your answer. Here's your result. Poor first touch. Poor second touch. Here he puts in an astonishing tackle, tackling the ground. You know, it's just the lowest point of his career. And, you know, we love him. We wish him the best. And I hope that this video serves as a stepping block or a springboard for Scooter as he moves forward. I certainly hope that it does not serve as a guillotine to sever his love for football and the game of FIFA. This clip here is what it's all about. A band of brothers. The four of us, the good old boys, standing with one another, hoisting this invisible trophy that thankfully EA Games has finally fixed in this latest update and patch. I also leave you with these clips so that the world will recognize who's really in charge here. The good old boys. You.
Fucking with me, man. He-man, ski-man, spending next week's cash. He fast, and I don't even need a G-pass. I'm past that. I'm passing them out now, and you can't have that. Hit my chain, too, can't Sam. That tropical colors, you can't match that. Gotta be abstract. You catch my girl, legs open, better smash that. Don't be surprised if she asks where the cash at. I see she wearing them jeans that show her butt crack. My girls can't wear that. Why? That's where my stash at. I put my Mac down, that's where you lack at. She need a candle lit, and I'ma wax that. I rekindled the flame, she remembered the name. His easy baby, January, December,
the same. They just stood off him as if to say, go on, then have a go.
Off we go again, 2-1.
Now here's
but
a
I'm piped up. See that boy right up? He piped up. See that girl right up? She piped up.
Pipe it up, pipe it up. Pipe it up, 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 pipe it up. I walk in the club just to pipe it up. I stand on the stage and I pipe it up. Get a regular hotel, I pipe it up. Go buy a bando, then I pipe it up. Pipe it up. She was a basic bitch till I piped her up.
She was a basic.
I'm just doing my dab, I call it the pipe it up.
Damn.
They know that I'm having blue Benjamins. They know I'm on top of the pyramid. They know I'ma go to the Guinness. All this dab a nigga drippin'.
Damn.
Piped up in the city.
Piped up
with your bitches.
Piped up
intervention.
Piped up
new edition.
Ay.
When a nigga start talking shit, gotta pipe up the ammunition.
Rah.
Yo bitch walking around piped up. When she see me, she blowing kisses.
Nah.
Feeling like Aladdin, Quavo the genie. I grant your whole three wishes.
Genie.
You know I do magic, Quavo Houdini. I touch the pack and get it missing.
Pipe it up,
pipe it up, pipe it up, pipe it up, pipe it up, pipe it up, pipe it up, pipe it up, pipe it up. I walk in the club just to pipe it up. I stand on the stage and I pipe it up. Get a regular hotel, I pipe it up. Go buy a bando and I pipe it up. Pipe it up, 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 pipe it up. I walk in the club just to pipe it up. I stand on the stage and I pipe it up. Get a regular hotel, I pipe it up. Go buy a bando, then I pipe it up.
But niggas still saying turn it up. I'm a young rich nigga screaming, I pipe it up. Benjamins all day, I feel like a dinosaur. Look at your diamonds ain't bright enough. I seen the words you dudes in the catapult. Play with that dope in the snow like a hockey puck. Pipe it up, no ride that piper. They biting the floor, nigga, but the nigga got the title. So that nigga dabbing don't know how it happened. I been touched down on you, nigga, ass matter. Don't forget, bitch, on the dad, daddy in stores now, wire in fast. Pipe it up, bitches gon' beat it. New anthem, my cup is swerving in the black panorama. Pull out the camera when you see me, Christian Louboutin hopping. Now that's an animal. Now remember, but we made this song. Nobody say pop it up. Now that we drop it, we gon' fuck em up and have everybody screaming, pipe it up.
Pipe it up.
Pipe it up in the club while I'm on drugs. Your nigga fucking up the furniture.
Fuck it up.
Shoot a money ball like Steve Kerr. Pop it up, I got them pipes on reserve.
Pipe it up. 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 I walk in the club just to pipe it up. I stand on the stage and I pipe it up. Get a regular hotel, I pipe it up.